on the neck of the fallow deers, and we keep them in quarantine for a few days. We monitor them and we treat their possible injuries. When we consider that the animals are in good health condition, we mobilize the animals again. We transport them to the capturing place and let them go. In some cases, when the general condition of the animals is good, we let them free immediately after installing the collar in order to avoid the intense stress. It is also important to investigate the disturbing effect of hunting, so we register the datum, the place, the number of hunters, and the number of shot animals of collective hunting occurring on the habitat territory. Data processing has been done with RQ and Digitera software to investigate the size of the home range and minimum convex polygon method was used and to investigate the daily activity we used, the distance between the location coordinates, and we connected the two measured points by linear interpolation. Result of home range investigation. On the maps, one can see the yearly home ranges of the different individuals, but registered in different years during the 10 years project. So, dependence of home range from the sex is well illustrated by the size of the home range of males and females in spring. The home range of males in spring is bigger than the one of females and appears the use of agricultural lands. Females with calf preferred to the forested areas and use smaller areas. Dependence of home range from season is illustrated by the home range size of males in summer and winter period. The food abundance in summer resulted smaller home range, mostly with agricultural areas, whilst the lack of food and the snow in winter time resulted a bigger home range and stronger woodlands use. In the rutting season, the home range of female is smaller than in summer, whilst the home range of males is 10 times bigger than in summer. The males visit several different rutting places, that's why their home range is bigger in rutting season. So, result on the daily activity. The activity gradually decreased and reserved the average value specific for the season within 1 month. One can notice that the average daily distance made by the females starting from the middle of season are higher than the distance made by males. The distance made by the fallow deers show two relevant peaks, one around the sunrise and one around the sunset, resulting two peak graph, this and this. The locomotion of fallow deer in summer period is stronger around the sunrise and sunset, in case of females and males also, here and here. On the graph, on the graph on can notice a locomotion peak in case of males in the rutting period in mid-October. This topic will be discussed later also. The locomotion of female is uniform. The daily activity of fallow deer in autumn becomes unsystematic. An interpretation can be that the red deer, which lives in the same place with the fallow deer populations, starts its rutting in September and starts its hunting with strong disturbance of the habitat. In this period, the males have minimal relaxation time. Most of the time, they all move and all rut. So in winter before sunrise appears a minimum in activity, around sunrise 8 or 9 o'clock, there is a lower peak in activity, whilst there is a strong peak around sunset, 17 or 18 o'clock. In conclusion, in contrast with the summer activity pattern, in winter a strong sunset peak is typical both for fallow deer females and males. Here and here. Thank you for attention.